should be us. I think that's everything. Feel free to utilize the chat facility that we have there. You can leave your comments. If you've got any questions, I'd be more than happy to answer those for you. We're gonna start off in our basic stance with our body. Check your alignment throughout your feet, your knees, your hips, ribcage, shoulders, chin, crown of the head, tailbone. Deep breath in here. Deep breath in, expand the belly, your ribcage. And as you breathe out, sinking deep down, I'm gonna move my hair away from the mic there. Before we come into some tech issues, let me just move this cable. Oh, I can't find it. Sorry about that. Deep breath in. And as you breathe out, coming down into body, deep breath in. Breathing out. We could take that over to one side, breathing all the way into fingertips. As you breathe out, pass through center, take it to the other side in your own time, breathing in. Into center there, all the way upwards. You can start now to flow life through the wrists, the hands, fingertips, circling through the wrist, all the way through. As you warm up through your body, make the movements small to start with. You can make them bigger from there. We're going to weave our hands, that painting motion. So you're going to flex through your wrist on the way down, on the way back upwards. You're going to just allow your fingertips to be the last thing that moves there. And it's this alternating. If you want to, you can bend through your knee and just begin to bend slightly into there. It's not a back bend, we're bending through the knee. Coming in through center here, you can make that movement gradually bigger. Bend through your knee. Lift your gaze to the sky, bring it back into center. Let's slow that down, make that movement real big as feels comfortable for you today. I'm going to take that gradually round towards the side. Nice. Wow. All right, let's focus now on the mechanics of that movement that we just did. You're going to roll your shoulder back on one side, then roll it all the way forwards, up, back and down on the other. Then we're going to alternate them. So you've got forwards, up, back, down, forwards, up, back, down. And we've got the upper arm begins to join in with that movement. The elbow is going to gently come up towards the sky, down to the ground, up to the sky, down to the ground. Let's open that out to the side. The forearm enjoys joining in. Your wrist all the way down through your hand, towards your fingers, and lastly your fingertips, well, and then your nails. Whee! It's so beautiful, it's really uplifting. Bring that into center, and the other thing of course is it's really toning. Bend through those knees, bring it back into center. Other side, bend, back into center. Here, we're gonna reverse camel up to the sky. Lengthen all the way through. I want you just to feel your feet really press into the ground now. We're gonna do one of those full body shimmies that we've done before. And you're picking this up either through the lift and lower of your heels, the bend of your knees, or a little combination of both. Bring your hands gently down. This is really, really grounding. It's going to bring you down into your body. Relax through your shoulders and your arms. Suddenly I feel nice and cozy. Feels hot. Coming into center. You can make that faster in that movement. And returning back into center here, into stillness. Wow. Let's come with a slide of the hip out to one side. Bend through that supporting knee to keep the hip line level, lengthen through your waist. Bring it through center, out to the other side. And you want to feel this almost like a stretch. Other side. And then we're going to link that movement together all as one. So you're going to pass through center and out to the other side. Through center, slide. Center, slide. Center, slide. A little bit faster. One, two, three, four, one, two. Well done. And bring the hands round. Bring them in towards heart space. In to genie pose. And try here, keep your upper half nice and still and steady using those anchoring muscles. Can you remember which muscles we're using to anchor through your upper half? If you can remember, during the water break coming up in a moment, see if you can key it into the comments. Slide, 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 slide. Here we go. One, two, three, four. If you're not sure the answer to that question at all, you'll find it within the Belly Basics playlist on YouTube. Four, three, two, one. We're gonna hear anchor through the low half, slide through the upper half, slide, slide. You can add in that movement that we did. You might know that to be called Egyptian arms or snaky arms. It's that flowing wave of energy that travels all the way actually from your belly through your rib cage up to your shoulders, down through your arms, to your wrist, hands, fingers, and all the way to your fingernails as well. Whee! Slide the rib cage. This movement here is just asking to turn into a figure of eight. Do you feel it wanting to grow outwards in direction from the rib cage? Rib cage comes all the way up and round. So you're gonna slide upwards on diagonal. Imagine a ribbon attached to the low section of your ribcage and you're gently being held up on a diagonal and then guided down towards the ground. Here, you're gonna slide upwards on the other side, bring it round and down. And we can loop that all together so it comes through slide and coming down, slide and down. Slide, lower. Slide, it comes round and down. So you're going to extend outwards and round, just like you would with your hip. You're going to push it outwards whilst sliding lower to the ground. This movement here can be reversed. Let's try. So we're going to come up towards the sky, and you're going to slide down diagonal with that rib cage. That movement here, the biggest movement pattern is coming from the low section of rib cage, and you're going to bring it all the way up and round. All the way up to the sky. And then you're gonna slide the whole rib cage with the low section of rib cage making the biggest movement pattern. It comes on diagonal here, and then it comes all the way up and round. The hips remain in neutral. So we're gonna slide, come round. Slide, come round. Slide, come round. Slide, and round. Slide, slide. You can cross your arms in front, slide all the way round, slide, bring it round. Bit faster. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two. Let's try to reverse. We're gonna come all the way up, bring it down towards the ground. So this is a figure of eight through your chest. And it's vertical, it travels up and down. It's flat, you could dance this against the mirror there. It doesn't move on a horizontal that way. There we go. Then with that movement, let's take that down into the hips. We've got a vertical figure of eight through the hips there. Wow. Yes. So you're gonna use that bend of your knee, really, really bend through your knee, and then slide down on diagonal. Bring it all the way up and round. Well done, everybody. Well done, you guys. Andrina doing well there. Really bend through your knee and then slide down diagonal. That's it, that's it. Bring it all the way up towards the top. You're gonna slide down. Bring it up towards the top. So what we've got going on there is two planes of motion. One of them is the same element as you would do in a hip drop on a single leg. So this up and down motion, this up and down motion like this, using the bend of your knee. The other action that you've got going on is actually a slide. So that slide motion there, where you really extend the hip out to the side, you've utilized that as well. So here, what we're gonna do is the equivalent of doing a hip drop on one side. Then you're gonna use that slide action, but here it's on the diagonal, and you're gonna come all the way down to the ground, really bend, 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 bend. Look how much both of my knees are bent here. Can you see that? Huge big bend through knees. We're gonna really bend, and then use that slide and push out to the side. Remember, you wanna feel that element of stretch through the waist. Yes, come all the way up towards the sky. And as you come to the peak of that diagonal there, you've almost fully outstretched through both knees, but there's a tiny little bend just to protect the knee joint. Then on the other side, slide down through diagonal, bend, 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 huge bend to your knees on the other side. See this diagonal this side now? Good, and then we're gonna push upwards and outwards, use the extension of the knee and the lengthening through the waist. Really feel that stretch through the waist. Come all the way up to the top there. So we're gonna bend, extend, bend, extend, bend, extend, bend, extend. Well done. So one of the benefits that you guys who are joining me live right here, right now in Zoom, in this Patreon exclusive Zoom class, you guys have the added benefit right now of being able to see what I'm doing, enjoying all of that tuition, but you can also have a little snapshot, have a look at yourself in your own little window on Zoom. You can use that like you were in class with me, and that's your mirror. Your little box there on Zoom, use your own image there as your mirror, yeah? I'm gonna turn towards this mirror and you can dance along with me here. We're gonna speed that up a little bit. Same movement, down, up. Well done, down, up. Yes. So just shifting your gaze between, as you probably have been doing naturally anyway, but if you're with me on Zoom right now, you might as well utilize your focus both on my screen, but also on your own. And then you can really see where you're going with it. Whee! And of course we can do that. We're a completely non-judgmental group. You would find that nobody's actually really fussed to see what you're doing. They're really interested in everybody's development there. Well done. So I'm just gonna chat to you through the mirror. We can frame that movement then with the hands. Wow. So here, let's try reverse that movement. We're gonna bring it up and over, bring it all the way round and down. Well done. Bring it up and over. Up and over. Up, down, up, down. So this one, slide up diagonal, bring it down. Try keep your heels flat on the floor. Wee! Four. Three. Two. And one. Wow! Woohoo! Amazing! Help yourself to a little spot of hydration. Now, remember the question. Can you remember which muscles we're using to anchor through? Let's say the upper half. If we're anchoring through the upper half, what muscles are we using to do that? Just have a little bash at the answer. In my book, there is actually no wrong answers, because if you get it wrong, if you don't get it spot on, what's happened there? You've learned something. Excuse me, just take a quick drink. All right, so remember I mentioned that you might want to have a veil handy for this next section. Our desert floor is very hot. Hot like the Sahara right now, so I've just turned that down. Okay, and so if you have got a veil handy, Andrina, I have looked out the veils that I have in stock and I'm going to photograph those for you after class. Now that you had asked what was available. So, in the meantime, you can totally dance this with a veil or without. So, what we had last time was that focus towards introducing the veil with a basic stance of your body and a basic grip with your hands. So let's just refresh our memories of that. So having a piece of fabric, preferably finished on the edges, roughly about 2 meters long and about 1 meter wide. We spoke last time about the way that different fabrics travel through the air. And I mentioned that I could really talk about that for a long time and a lot of depth, and fully express to you everything that you want to know about the wonders and the beauty of dancing with a veil. But for now, we settled on something that's a chiffon, or maybe a georgette fit chiffon, a single silk, although we spoke about how a single silk will definitely challenge you if you're not used to dancing with the veil. So here I have a chiffon. You're gonna use a scissor grip right now, which is one of the two main grips that I recommend. The scissor grip like this, snip, 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 it's a scissor grip. That'll help you remember it, huh? Snip, 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 it's a scissor grip. So you're gonna go about 1/3 of the way along one end. This one, a little bit perhaps shorter than some, which can be very handy for specific movements and very handy for beginners. On the other side, you're gonna do exactly the same thing. Make sure you have the veil right up at the top of your fingers. You're making a T shape there. You want to be able to wrap it around you, but also form a straight line with that top edge so you can really control the veil. We're gonna start off with waves. So in your basic stance with your body, make sure you bend through your knees in your basic stance, and that's gonna help you to not hyperextend through your back. Here we're working with that sweeping painting hand that we did previously. Nice. And then what we had was around the world. You're gonna bring the veil all the way around behind you. And then when you get to the back, you're gonna start to bring it forwards. Make sure you've got bent through your knees, you're not hyperextending through your back. It's in neutral. Coming all the way around, you're gonna allow the hands to circle out in front of you, sweeping around to bring the right one all the way up behind you and up overhead. Both hands come up overhead. The right one comes down. The left one follows. The right one comes all the way around from underneath. It comes out behind you. And then we return back to center. We could take that the other way around. The left hand comes down. So I'm, of course, mirroring you right now to just simplify things. On receiving end of that. So on the other side, the left hand comes down. The right hand follows. The left hand comes all the way up and behind you. It sweeps round and up into center. Well done. You can bring both hands up on top of your head. Place both hands on top of your head, just behind your head here, up into princess pose. Let me move my hair, which is now tangled on the mic. There we go. And so let me try that. Let's just have another shot of that. I'm going to face the other direction so you can have a clear idea of what we're doing here. So we've got the veil out behind us here. Make sure you got that scissor grip. You could start with it in front of you if that's easier for you as a beginner. The scissor grip of the veil there. We're in our basic stance with our body. Bend through your knees. Let's start with the right hand first. It's going to cross in front of you. It's going to come all the way up towards your left side, and then it's going to start to make its way towards your right hand side as the left hand comes up to join it. From here, your right hand's going to continue to travel down to the side. It's going to sweep round in front of you. So you're pointing, almost pointing in front of you a few feet there with your hand, yeah? The left hand now is going to come all the way round, and it's going to do the same. So that you're essentially in this position here, halfway through this movement. So the other half of this movement, you'll be up like this. So you go from here to down here. You go from here to up here, from here to down here. And what we do on the outside edges of that, if you bring the veil in front of you, let's try that again. So to get to that hands up over your head in that Y shape, you're gonna bring your right hand, sweep it across in front of you over the top of that left hand. And then you're gonna bring it all the way up to the side of you like that. And then you're gonna start to allow the left hand to follow. Coming, sweeping all the way round, the right hand begins to come down in front of you. The left hand is going to come over the top of your right hand and it's going to meet you in here. So you've got this little circling round motion as you do that, if you want to make that super fancy. Come all the way round and you're going to allow the hands to cross in front of you as you bring it out towards the side. So bring it all the way down and then you've got this cross motion in front of you where you kind of make a whirlwind, a whirlpool of veil in front of you. So let me just show you that facing you so you can see what I'm doing in that whirlwind motion. So as we come down, you're gonna allow the hands to cross in front. You're gonna whirlwind out in front of you and bring that right hand up and over your head. Yeah, let's try that again. You're going to come all the way down. Your left hand comes all the way out and round. This is my right hand, but I'm, as you see, it's my left. Come all the way round, off into center again. So when you do that a little bit faster, are you ready? Bring the veil out in front. Here we go. One, two, three, four. Sweep. One, two, three, four. So you can do slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, 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 quick, quick, slow, 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 quick, quick, slow, 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 quick, quick, slow. One, two, three, and four. One, two, three and four. One, two, three. And bring your hands up on top of your head. Wow! gonna drop through our hip with the veil up on top behind you. Drop, 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 drop. Into that figure of eight that we did. Other side, drop. Drop through your hip. Drop, 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 drop. Hand comes out. Drop, drop, drop. Figure of eight, wow. Wow, 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 wow. Woohoo! Bring the veil all the way around towards the front. That figure of eight motion. Nice. Bring your hands into heart space. Genie pose. Reverse that eight. And then we're going to do that up, over, and release. So take your hands wider. Remember we did gaze, lift your gaze. So you're going to do up, over with the veil to bring it towards the back of you. And you're going to release it. So it's going to make its own way down towards the ground. You're going to lift your gaze and make a beautiful poise, pose in any way that feels good for you. Are you ready? 4, 3, 2, 1. Up, over, release. Wow, stunning. As we said before, one of the things whenever people start dancing with the veil, they start to get a little bit worried that they're gonna drop it. We're gonna practice dropping the veil a lot. And then if it ever happens outside of that, it's part of the dance, it's part of the movement. The veil is an extension of you. It's an extension of your expression. It's an extension of your femininity and your beauty. It's gorgeous and it's color therapy at the same time. What's not to love? What's not to love? Always being aware of your surroundings, safety always coming first. So you're gonna be careful not to slide. If you're wearing any sort of jewelry, you might want to make it quick release. If you're wearing eyewear, as I was earlier, actually, I found my glasses. Yeah. I've not worn glasses in ages. It was so much fun. Anyway, you might want to take them off or use contacts or just be aware. Similarly with hair pieces, anything like that, just being super careful and cautious. Never dance with a veil with a naked flame. I'd be careful with incense as well. I'm telling you this at the end of the session, at the next session, the beginning, you'll be ready for that. Here we go. You're gonna, this is the best way to pick up your veil. You're gonna look for an edge just from the corner of your eye. Your audience doesn't even notice. And then maybe it's in the center of your veil, which makes it easier for folding when you're finished using it. You're gonna just look for that edge. Woo! Wow. And then popping your veil aside, help yourself to some hydration, and then join me in a lovely cool down stretch. Wow. Lifting hands up to the sky, take a big wide stance, dip through your knees. We're gonna come out towards one side, frame your belly, frame your face. We're gonna release through the waist. Bring it on diagonal, release through the back. Into center, we're gonna come out through one vertebrae at a time, back into center. Oh, so good, huh? Other side, with that bend through the knee, we're gonna come out towards the side. Frame through your belly, frame through your face. Releasing all the way through. Coming on diagonal there. Release through the back. Into center, we're gonna unwind one vertebrae at a time, coming all the way back into center. One foot out in front, bring it round, lift up, grip on. Knees into alignment. And again, you can use this one, balancing against something, or challenge your balance as is. in the center of your space. Take a deep breath in as you breathe out. Let's release that down. This is where you notice that actually you've been using your whole body, particularly using the legs and your hips and your glutes during those gorgeous figures of eight we did. Beautiful figures of eight, those vertical figures of eight through the rib cage and through the hips today. Wow. Really good for toning and strengthening. Let's take a deep breath in. And all of those hand and arm movements that we did, stunning, so beautiful. Wow, so expressive and feminine. Floaty, but strong. Take the hands up overhead. And in four, in three, in two, in one, make your move. Wow, 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 wow. That was gorgeous. Woohoo, I hope you'll join me next time for more fun. Woo, more crazy hip movements that feel fantastical and lots more veil dancing. Wow. If you've enjoyed this video, please remember to like, subscribe and hit notifications so you can be informed of when the next video goes up. If you'd like to support the creation of these videos, remember you can head along to patreon.com/littleegyptstudio where you'll find a community of other enjoyers of these videos. See you soon. Bye.